Son and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Today we celebrate both Cyril of Jerusalem, who was Archbishop of Constantinople, the new imperial city, in the 4th century. Cyril became a doctor of the church. Because of his teaching, his standing up to the heresies of Arius, Cyril had a checkered career, like anybody who works at the heart of government, coming into contact, into conflict, either with the emperor or with the empress, or with the emperor's mother. Must have been a complicated life. Anyway, today is also in the church an Ember Day, when we pray for those who are to be ordained. Ordinations in the UK have been delayed, but today in Paris, Stéphanie Burette and Jean Drummond Chavan are being ordained by Bishop Mark Eddington, a priest in his cathedral. That's either at 12 or at 1. They and the website seem to differ about this, but anyway, it's going to happen in a properly socially distanced fashion. We pray for them and for all those who are to be ordained priests, that they may be formed after the heart of Christ. Let us confess the times then when we have also failed.
Could I have
there isn't any paper. Oh, right. Don't worry, it's all designed so that you don't have to read it.
I beg your pardon.
Don't worry. So we confess the times when we have failed to be formed after the heart of Christ. Lord Jesus, you said to your disciples, "You have not chosen me, but I have chosen you. Lord, have mercy."
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, we know that the harvest is plentiful, but the labourers are few. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you appointed us to go and bear fruit that will last. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Amen. Let us pray the prayer for today. Almighty God, the giver of all good gifts, by your Holy Spirit you have appointed various orders of ministry in the church. Look with mercy on your servants, now called to be deacons and priests, especially Stéphanie and Jean Drummond. Maintain them in truth and renew them in holiness, that by word and good example they may faithfully serve you, to the glory of your name and the benefit of your church, through the merits of our Saviour Jesus Christ, who is alive and reigns in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
We're seated now to listen to the scriptures. A reading from the Book of Lamentation. The Lord has destroyed without mercy all the dwellings of Jacob. In his wrath he has broken down the strongholds of daughter Judah. He has brought down to the ground in dishonour the kingdom and its rulers. The elders of daughter Zion sit on the ground in silence. They have thrown dust on their heads and put on sackcloth. The young girls of Jerusalem have bowed their heads to the ground. My eyes are spent with weeping, my stomach churns, my bile is poured out on the ground because of the destruction of my people, because infants and babes faint in the streets of the city. They cry to their mothers, "Where is bread and wine?" as they faint like the wounded in the streets of the city, as their life is poured out on their mother's bosom. What can I say for you? To what compare you, O daughter Jerusalem? To what can I liken you, that I may comfort you, O virgin daughter Zion? For vast as the sea is your ruin, who can heal you? Your prophets have seen for you false and deceptive visions. They have not exposed your iniquity to restore your fortunes, but have seen oracles for you that are false and misleading. Cry aloud to the Lord, O wall of daughter Zion. Let tears stream down like a torrent day and night. Give yourself no rest, your eyes no respite. Arise, cry out in the night at the beginning of the watches, Pour out your heart like water before the presence of the Lord. Lift your hands to him for the lives of your children who faint for hunger at the head of every street. The response to the psalm, do not forget the lives of your poor forever. Do not forget the lives of your poor forever. O God, why have you utterly disowned us? Why does your anger burn against the sheep of your pasture? Do not forget the lives of your poor forever. Remember your congregation that you purchased of old, the tribe you redeemed for your own possession, and Mount Zion where you dwelt. Hasten your steps towards the endless ruins where the enemy has laid waste all your sanctuary. Do not forget the lives of your poor forever. Arise, O God, maintain your own cause. Remember how fools revile you all the day long. Forget not the clamour of your adversaries, the tumult of your enemies that ascends continually. Do not forget the lives of your poor forever.
Alleluia.
Disciples of all the nations.
Alleluia, Alleluia, Alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Hear the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to Matthew.
Glory to you, Lord.
When Jesus entered Capernaum, a centurion came to him, appealing to him, and saying, Lord, my servant is lying at home paralyzed, in terrible distress. And he said to him, I will come and cure him. The centurion answered, Lord, I am not worthy to have you come under my roof, but only speak the word, and my servant will be healed. For I also am a man under authority, with soldiers under me, and I say to one, go, and he goes, and to another, come, and he comes, and to my slave, do this, and the slave does it. When Jesus heard him, he was amazed, and said to those who followed him, Truly I tell you, in no one in Israel have I found such faith. I tell you, many will come from east and west, and will eat with Abraham and Isaac and Jacob in the kingdom of heaven, while the heirs of the kingdom will be thrown into the outer darkness, where there will be weeping and gnashing of teeth. And to the centurion Jesus said, Go, let it be done for you according to your faith. And the servant was healed in that hour. And when Jesus entered Peter's house, he saw his mother-in-law lying in bed with a fever. He touched her hand, and the fever left her, and she got up and began to serve him. That evening they brought to him many who were possessed by demons, and he cast out the spirits with a word, and cured all who were sick. This was to fulfill what had been spoken through the prophet Isaiah. He took our infirmities and bore our diseases. This is the gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Christ.
We are all one in Christ Jesus. We belong to him through faith, heirs of the promise of the Spirit of peace. The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
Please sit down as the altar is prepared. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. creation. Through your goodness we have this bread to offer, which earth has given and human hands have made. It will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. Through your goodness we have this wine to offer, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give thanks and praise.
It is indeed right and good, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, through your servant, Jesus Christ our Lord. At his baptism he was revealed as your beloved Son, and coming among us as one who serves, he taught that they are greatest in your kingdom, who make themselves least and the servants of all. Although he was their teacher and their Lord, he washed the feet of his disciples and commanded us to do the same. Through your Holy Spirit, you bestow upon your people a rich diversity of gifts and ministries. And from this royal priesthood, you raise up men and women to proclaim your word, to care for your people, and to be the stewards of the mysteries of Christ. You call them to serve the world your Son redeemed, and build up his body, the Church, to the greater glory of your name. And so with angels and archangels and all the heavenly host, we proclaim your glory and join their unending hymn of praise.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
Lord, you are holy indeed, the source of all holiness. Grant that by the power of your Holy Spirit and according to your holy will, these gifts of bread and wine may be to us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, who in the same night that he was betrayed took bread and gave you thanks. He broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take, eat. This is my body which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." In the same way, after supper, he took the cup and gave you thanks. He gave it to them, saying, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you drink it, in remembrance of me." Great is the mystery of faith.
Christ
has died. Christ is risen. Christ will come again. And so, Father, calling to mind his death on the cross, his perfect sacrifice made once for the sins of the whole world, rejoicing in his mighty resurrection and glorious ascension, and looking for his coming in glory, we celebrate this memorial of our redemption. As we offer you this, our sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving, we bring before you this bread and this cup, and we thank you for counting us worthy to stand in your presence and serve you. Send the Holy Spirit on your people and gather into one in your kingdom all who share this one bread and one cup, so that we in the company of Mary, Virgin Mother of God, George, Genevieve, and Cyril of Jerusalem and all the saints may praise and glorify you forever through Jesus Christ our Lord, by whom and with whom and in whom, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honour and glory be yours, Almighty Father, for ever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
So as our Saviour has taught us then, we are bold to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen. We break this bread to share in the body of Christ. Though we are many, we are one body, because we all share in one bread. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Behold the Lamb of God, who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called to his supper. Lord, I am not worthy to receive you, but only say the word, and I shall be healed. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, whose ascended Son gave gifts of leadership and service to the Church, strengthen us who have received this holy food to be good stewards of your manifold gift, grace, through him who came not to be served, but to serve, and give his life as a ransom for many, Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
Amen. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
May the boldness of the Spirit transform you. May the gentleness of the Spirit lead you. May the gifts of the Spirit equip you to serve and worship God. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be among you and remain with you always.
Amen.
The Mass has ended. Go in the peace of Christ.